Hello students, this is Purushottam Vishwakarma and today we are going to start a new lesson in class 10th SST chapter 3 in economics, money and credit. But before we start anything in this chapter, we must understand what is the concept of money. Money is a fascinating subject and full of curiosities. What is money? It has been since the emergence of civilization in different forms, in gold, silver, copper, and at present the money is seen in the form of paper notes and coins. So what is this money? Money is an item which is used as a medium of exchange. Suppose you want to purchase anything from market, what will you need? Money. Before emergence of money, when there was no money in the world, people used to deal in goods, and that system was known as barter system. So what was this barter system? Barter system simply means exchange of goods. Suppose there was a person A having some grain. With A there was some grain and with B there was a hen. Person A wanted a hen and person B wanted grain. So what did they do? They exchanged their goods to each other. So in this way, in starting, barter system was practiced. Now let's see the chapter. The first heading we have, money as a medium of exchange. The very first heading in this chapter we have, money as a medium of exchange. What is this money? As I have told you, money is an item which is used as a medium of exchange. The use of money spans a very large part of our everyday life. It is used in our day-to-day life. Our day starts with the spending of money and ultimately it ends with the spending of money. From morning till late night we use money for purchasing goods, for purchasing services and many more. Have you ever wondered why transactions are made in money? Now the question is, have you ever wondered, did you ever care, why? Why do people give money in return of any good or services? Why do they transact using money? The reason is simple. What is the reason? The reason is quite simple. A person holding money can easily exchange it for any commodity or service that he or she might want. Thus, everyone prefers to receive payment in money and then exchange the money for things that they want. So money is the best medium of exchange. It is acceptable by each and everyone. Now the condition occurs, especially when we talk about barter system. What is barter system? Barter system is exchange of goods with goods. I have told you the example of A and B. But there is a situation. There must be two parties, A and B. One may be seller, A may be seller, while B buyer. So there must be two parties, a seller and a buyer. If this situation is not present, then there will be no trade. So it is compulsory, there must be a seller and buyer. And where will it happen? It will happen in market. Both parties have to agree. Party A and B have to agree to sell and buy each other's commodities. I'm talking about especially barter system. Both parties must be agree to sell or to buy. This is known as double coincidence of wants. And this situation is known as double coincidence of wants. Double coincident means both parties must be in condition of selling as well as purchasing. There must be a seller as well as a buyer. What a person desires to sell is exactly what the other wishes to buy. Suppose person A had some shoes and person B some grain, wheat. That is not sufficient. The two persons having shoes and wheat. Person B must need shoes and person A must need grains, wheat. So that situation is known as double coincidence of wants. Both must want the things. A must want wheat while B must want shoes. In a barter system where goods are directly exchanged without the use of money, double coincidence of want is an essential feature. As I told you, what is barter system? Barter system is a situation when goods are exchanged with goods. So it is compulsory for that situation. What is compulsory? Double coincidence of wants. When there is a buyer and there is a seller and both required the essential relating to other. In contrast, in an economy where money is in use, in an economy like nowadays we have, in contradictory way, money by providing the crucial intermediate step eliminates the need of double coincidence of want. But nowadays, with the emergence of money, this double coincidence of want is not required. Why? Because of money. You can purchase anything from a shop without thinking about this situation that is known as double coincidence of wants. So money has eliminated the requirement of the situation of double coincidence of wants. It is no longer necessary for the shoe manufacturer, as you have seen the example of shoe manufacturer and grain, to look for a farmer who will buy his shoes and at the same time sell him grains. Since money acts as an intermediate in the exchange process, it is called a medium of exchange. I have told you, what is money? Money is an item which is used as a medium of exchange because it helps in the transaction. It helps in the exchange process. That is why it is called a medium of exchange. I hope you understood the concept of money and barter system. What is money? Money is an item which is used as a medium of exchange. We have been using money since civilization. Money is a fascinating subject and full of curiosity. Now, barter system. Barter system is a situation where exchange of goods is done. In the system, goods are given in return of goods because there is no emergence of currency. There is no emergence of such concept like money. Now let's see modern forms of money. What are the modern forms of money? You can see here in the picture. Early punch marked coins may be 2500 years old. You can see here in the picture. These punch marked stamped coins having no particular shape, but because of their mark, punch mark, they were acceptable in particular kingdom. Further, you can see Gupta coins here, Tughlaq coin, gold mohar from Akbar reign, and modern coin. You can see here modern coin, rupee 1. So it has a long journey from early era. Now it has come to modern form of currency. And what is the modern form of currency? Paper notes and coin. Modern forms of currency. Before the introduction of coins, a variety of objects was used as money. What were the objects? You can notice here For example, since the very early ages, Indians used grains and cattle as money. I gave you the example of grain as hen. Thereafter came the use of metallic coins in form of gold, silver, copper, a phase which continued well into the last century. That was in use till last century. Now, what is currency? Nowadays, we call money in the form of currency. Modern forms of money include currency, paper notes and coins. Nowadays, modern forms of currency basically are paper notes and coins. Some others are also there. Different bonds, credit cards, and many more we'll discuss further. But basically, modern forms of money include currency like paper notes and coins. The modern currency is without any use of its own. I would like to tell you, when we have gold coins, that gold can also be used in different purposes. And that gold has the same value of its own. 10 gram gold has the same value of its value of that coin. But nowadays, 10 rupee note that is made of paper doesn't have any value of its own. It doesn't have any value of its own. So that is why it is said the modern currency is without any use of its own until it is punch marked, no use. If you remember, in 2016, there came demonetization. What is demonetization? Prime Minister banned the old notes, old currency notes of rupees 500 and 1000. So that notes were of no use. You can simply understand, you can't use those notes in any other purpose. Useless. So in this way, you can say the modern currency is without any use of its own. Then what is the reason? Why is it accepted as a medium of exchange? Now the question arises, why it is accepted as a medium of exchange? The answer is, it is accepted as a medium of exchange because the currency is authorized by the government of the country. As I told you, the notes are useless until they have the signature of authorization of the government of India. In India, the Reserve Bank of India, especially the governor of Reserve Bank, in India, the Reserve Bank of India issues currency notes on behalf of the central government. Bank of India issues currency notes on behalf of the government, central government. No individual in India can legally refuse a payment made in rupees. But before that, I would like to remind you, a common man is not authorized to print a note. Only Reserve Bank of India has the right to publish, to print currency notes. Not only that, it is acceptable in India. No individual in India can legally refuse a payment made in rupees. It is acceptable all over India. Hence, the rupee is widely accepted as a medium of exchange. So, it is accepted all over India. That is why it is said it is widely accepted as a medium of exchange. Next is deposits with banks. So, the other form of currency. One form of currency we studied. What is that? One form of currency is currency notes and coins, paper notes and coins. The other, deposits with banks. We have deposited in bank. The other form in which people hold money is as deposits with banks. At a point of time, people need only some currency for their day-to-day needs. Suppose we earn 30,000 or 20,000 in a month. What do? We keep at least 15,000, 20,000 out of those 20-30 in bank and use the remaining 5,000, 10,000 in form of our household expenses. So, these remaining parts are safe with banks. People's money is safe with the banks. As it is supposed, people's money is safe with the bank. And it earns an amount of interest as well. If you keep money in bank, bank will also give you interest in return on your deposit. People also have the provision to withdraw the money as and when they require. And they have provision if you are
अ कस्टमर ऑफ अ बैंक यू हैव अथॉरिटी टू विदड्रॉ द मनी एज एंड वेन यू रिक्वायर, वेन एवर यू वॉन्ट यू कैन विदड्रॉ द मनी, यू कैन टेक योर मनी बैक. सिंस द डिपॉजिट्स इन द बैंक अकाउंट्स कैन बी विदड्रॉन ऑन डिमांड, बिकॉज दोज अमाउंट, दोज डिपॉजिटेड अमाउंट्स कैन बी विदड्रॉन ऑन योर डिमांड. यू कैन विदड्रॉ दोज मनी, दोज डिपॉजिट्स ऑन योर डिमांड. दीज आर नोन एज, दीज डिपॉजिट्स आर नोन एज, दीज आर कॉल्ड एज डिमांड डिपॉजिट्स. सो वॉट आर डिमांड डिपॉजिट्स? द मनी डिपॉजिटेड इन द बैंक विच कैन बी विदड्रॉन ऑन योर डिमांड. दीज फॉर्म्स ऑफ मनी डिपॉजिटेड इन द बैंक आर नोन एज डिमांड डिपॉजिट्स. डिमांड डिपॉजिट्स ऑफ अनदर इंटरेस्टिंग फैसिलिटी. वॉट इज अनदर इंटरेस्टिंग फैसिलिटी? इट इज दिस फैसिलिटी विच लेंड्स इट द इसेंशियल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ मनी, दैट ऑफ अ मीडियम ऑफ एक्सचेंज. वॉट अनदर फॉर्म्स ऑफ मीडियम ऑफ एक्सचेंज? यू वुड हैव हर्ड ऑफ पेमेंट्स बींग मेड बाई चेक्स. नाउ डेज मोस्ट ऑफ आवर ट्रांजेक्शन इज बींग डन डिजिटली. वी आर कमिंग टू डिजिटल एरा. आवर पेमेंट्स आर मोस्टली डन इन फॉर्म ऑफ डिजिटल करेंसी. बट सम मंथ्स एगो, सम टाइम बिफोर, चेक्स वर वेरी पॉपुलर. इवन टूडे चेक्स आर वेरी पॉपुलर. सो यू मे हैव हर्ड ऑफ पेमेंट बींग मेड बाई चेक्स इंस्टीड ऑफ कैश. पीपल मेड पेमेंट्स नॉट इन कैश बट इन फॉर्म ऑफ चेक्स. फॉर पेमेंट थ्रू चेक द पेयर हु हैज एन अकाउंट विद द बैंक. सो टू पे विद योर चेक यू मस्ट हैव अ वैलिड अकाउंट एंड अ चेक एज वेल. मेक्स आउट अ चेक फॉर अ स्पेसिफिक अमाउंट. अ चेक इज अ पेपर इंस्ट्रक्टिंग द बैंक टू पे अ स्पेसिफिक अमाउंट फ्रॉम द पर्सन अकाउंट टू द पर्सन इन हुज नेम द चेक हैज बीन इशूड. सपोज यू हैव टू पे मिस्टर राकेश, एन इमेजिनरी नेम, रुपीज 1 lakh. देन वट विल यू डू? इट्स नॉट ईजी टू विदड्रॉ 1 lakh फ्रॉम द बैंक एंड टू कैरी इट इन योर पॉकेट एंड गिव हैंड इन हैंड. सो वट इज एन ईजी टास्क? सिंपली टेक आउट योर चेकबुक एंड प्रिपेयर अ चेक ऑफ रुपीज 1 lakh इन द नेम ऑफ मिस्टर राकेश एंड डिपॉजिट इट. सेंड इट टू द रिसीवर. हु इज द रिसीवर? मिस्टर राकेश. As you can see in the picture, this is a check. From your textbook, this is a check. I would like to tell you some important things in this check. And in your life, you will further need to write checks. So it is very essential to know what is the check and how can you fill a check in a proper manner. First of all, as you can see here, account payee. You can see here, it is written account payee with 2 slanting lines. It means that you are safeguarding your check. This check, using these 2 lines and writing like that, account payee, means you are safeguarding your check. This payment will be done only to the account of the person. As you can see here, what is the person? Prem Kumar. This will be paid only to Mr. Prem Kumar, no one else. And how? In his account. So next thing, you need to fill the name of the person. But do remember, here, from pay itself, start writing from here. PURUSHOTTAM. Suppose I am writing my name. Don't leave any space. Furthermore, the most important, your signature. You have to signature here at this place. 2 more signatures are required at the back as well. So this is how to fill a check, how to give a check to any other person. Thus we see that demand deposits share the essential features of money. The facility of checks against demand deposits makes it possible to directly settle payments without the use of cash. You may have noticed in this process, when we pay with check, there is no involvement of cash. And it is safe as well. If you have made it account payee, no one else can withdraw money from your account, because that amount of check is going to be deposited only in the account of the receiver. Since demand deposits are accepted widely as a means of payment along with currency, they constitute money in the modern economy. So checks are also a form of money. They also constitute a form of money in modern economy. So that's all in this video. We'll continue the remaining in second part.